Hey everyone, today I'll share some crucial insights about Cline, both the strengths and challenges, to help you make the most of this tool. Cline's checkpoint system allows you to experiment with code changes and review them thoroughly before committing, ensuring your modifications match your intentions. Let me demonstrate this in action. I'll ask Cline to add a new help tab to a Chrome extension called Bolt to GitHub. I'll enter. Add a new tab after the settings tab called Help with proper icon. Add it as a separate component and add a simple help content. Before submitting, I will help Cline a bit by opening the app component because that's where the most probable starting point of the changes I expect Cline to make. The See New Changes button displays all modifications made in this task. Notice how Cline has updated multiple files. Now let's see the actual changes in the user interface. As we can see, Cline did a great job adding the new tab with sample content inside. Want to review changes at a specific point? Let's make another change to show this. I'll ask Cline to mention in the help that only public GitHub repos can be imported to Bolt. Let's see the changes in the user interface. Now let's review the task history. For each action, Cline creates a snapshot. While it's subtle, hovering over these snapshots reveals a compare button that shows the differences between your current code and its state at that point. This helps you evaluate whether to keep or revert changes. If you want to keep code changes but reset tasks up to a point, select Restore Task Only. As we can see, it preserved the code changes but deletes the task after the chosen point. To undo changes up to a certain point and discard everything after, use the Restore button with Restore Task and Workspace. This removes both the subsequent tasks and their code changes. Not happy with the change but want to preserve task history? Use Restore Workspace Only. But use this with caution. As mentioned here, task may become out of sync. Then try a different approach. For example, mention in the help that the extension cannot do anything if Bolt throws an error. And here we see that though we restored the previous change about removing the features section, Cline became out of sync with the task history and removed the features section again. So be careful when using this option. Once satisfied with the changes, you can commit them to Git. This feature gives you precise control over Cline's modifications within each task. Finally, delete the task to keep your workspace tidy. Sometimes, when we open files, we find several issues that would be tedious to fix one by one through individual prompts. Cline can automatically detect problems across multiple files using the VS Code Problems view. Here we can see several issues in both the new user guide component and the help component. We can ask Cline to fix all of these at once with a simple command. Please fix the @ problems. Cline immediately grabs all the problem details and begins fixing them one by one. With auto-approve enabled for reading and editing files, we don't need to manually approve each change. Watch as the issues in the problems view disappear one by one while Cline makes the fixes. While we could correct these issues manually or use VS Code's built-in tools without incurring AI costs, Cline makes it significantly easier to handle multiple workspace issues simultaneously. However, like any AI tool, the effectiveness of this feature depends on having deep knowledge of your codebase. It may miss complex architectural issues or make overly aggressive fixes that do more harm than good. That's why it's important to understand your code thoroughly and be selective about which fixes to apply. While custom instructions are user-specific and global, applying across all projects, the Cline rules file provides project-specific instructions that live in your project's root directory. These instructions automatically append to your custom instructions and appear in Cline's system prompt, influencing all interactions within the project. This makes it perfect for enforcing security best practices, consistent code standards, and development practices, especially protecting project architecture by preventing the mixing of incompatible tech stacks when AI makes code changes. Let me show this in action by creating a Cline rules file for security best practices. I'll paste in a sample from Cline's documentation. I've added the link in the description. Here, we've added rules, including one that prevents reading or modifying ENV files. Let's test this by asking Cline to read and update the ENV file. I'll tell Cline, "Can you read the ENV file and tell me the contents and secrets there?" In Cline's response, we see it follows the rules file and refuses to read or modify the ENV file. However, it notices a related ENV sample file and suggests reading that instead. So I'll ask, "Can you read the ENV sample file instead?" Cline successfully reads this file since it doesn't violate any of our specified rules. We don't have to write these rules by hand. We can ask Cline's help for best practices and coding standards. Let's ask Cline to read the project's main config files and come up with rules about the tech stack, making sure not to use incompatible packages and libraries, and enforce project standards best practices. Then, update the Cline rules file. Cline begins by analyzing the project's configuration files, package.json, TypeScript config, ESLint config, Prettier config, Byte config for build tooling, and Tailwind config for styling setup. After making necessary changes to the Cline rules file based on our example, we can enhance it further. Let's add a rule, limiting files to 300 lines of code. This helps prevent confusion and editing issues with AI development tools that can lead to messy code bases. Let's also add a rule about creating modular components to ensure Cline breaks down large files into smaller, reusable pieces. Now let's test the architectural protection rule by explicitly asking Cline to add a React component. Of course, we wouldn't do this in real projects, but I've seen AI tools make this mistake before. Having Cline rules protects our code base. While comprehensive Cline rules increase the input context size, they save time and resources in the long run by preventing inconsistencies before they occur. The rules proactively ensure code consistency across the project. However, be cautious when setting rules. They can easily become overly complex and create conflicts. This is why you should regularly maintain both your Cline rules file and custom instructions. When you clearly defined your task and trust Cline's capabilities, you can enable auto-approve actions. This feature allows Cline to work autonomously while you handle other tasks. You can customize which actions Cline can perform without approval, including reading files and directories, editing files, running save commands, using the browser, and accessing MCP servers. Let me demonstrate this in action. I'll ask Cline to set up linting and code formatting for this repository. Here's my prompt. First, analyze the project, then implement linting and code formatting tools following svelte best practices. Let's take a gradual approach to linting, keeping it lightweight initially. Add the required scripts to package.json, then run both linting and formatting checks. Don't apply any fixes yet. For this task, I'll enable auto-approve for reading and editing files, as well as execute safe commands. These settings are task-specific. Cline lets you choose the most suitable options for each task. However, I recommend leaving the Use the Browser option unchecked as it can significantly increase API costs. I'll also leave the MCP Servers option unchecked since I don't expect Cline to perform any MCP-related actions for this task. Auto-approve speeds up repetitive tasks and minimizes interruptions to your workflow. However, it can quickly spiral out of control with unexpected API costs and unwanted changes, and you might lose track of what's happening. Fortunately, you can set limits on unattended recommended actions to manage these risks. You can also enable notifications to stay informed when Cline completes a task. Remember to check the main auto-approve checkbox to enforce these settings. Now let's start the task and see how convenient these settings are. We see that Cline wants to execute a command. You might wonder why it's asking for permission when we enabled executing commands. This is because installing and adding dependencies isn't considered entirely safe, so let's explicitly approve Cline to run this command. Notice how Cline saves the new files without asking. It can also run safe commands like npm run lint automatically because these commands only check files for issues rather than modify them. Cline continues to update and fix issues to the files it created automatically. We can take a break while it works, but the process is usually quite fast. Another explicit command approval is needed since Cline updated a dependency. Let's approve it. Cline automatically runs npm run lint and npm run format to check for linting and formatting issues. After reviewing the results, we can ask Cline to fix the formatting using prettier. When it finds issues and updates the config, it asks permission to run npm run format colon fix, as this will modify multiple files. Since Prettier handles these formatting fixes automatically without AI involvement, it helps reduce API costs. While this initial setup does incur some expense, once we have linting and Prettier configured, we can run them independently without Cline or AI assistance. This demonstrates an important point. Not everything needs AI involvement. Many of these excellent development tools existed and worked well long before AI became mainstream. Looking at the updated files, we can see formatting improvements that, while not affecting functionality, significantly enhance code readability, crucial for team collaboration and maintainability. Cline's system prompt is massive. Let me demonstrate this by simply typing "Hey" in the prompt. The input tokens immediately jump to 14.8K without us doing anything else. This happens because the system prompt contains extensive information that isn't always necessary for every task. While this comprehensive approach helps Cline handle complex tasks with minimal instructions and better understand development contexts, it can be excessive for simple operations. Take the MCP-related section, for instance. Lines 339 to 742 are dedicated to it. Over 400 lines of prompt that get sent even when we're not using MCP. This leads to higher API costs per request and reduces the available space for our actual code requests, which becomes particularly problematic when using models with smaller context windows. Currently, there's no built-in way to disable specific parts of the system prompt. Though Cline is open source and we could technically modify it ourselves, doing so isn't straightforward. When working with Cline, it's easy to leave multiple tabs open. While this might seem harmless, it actually has a crucial impact on Cline's performance. Let me demonstrate. I have several files open here. Let's say I want to add support for fine-grained personal access tokens alongside classic personal access tokens for working with private GitHub repositories. When I start this task, which I'll cancel right away, you'll see that all open tabs are sent to the LLM in the API request. Though the response is reasonable in this case, having too many tabs open could potentially confuse the LLM. However, if we only open the most relevant file that Cline needs, it can better understand our intentions, even when we don't explicitly specify which file needs updating. These six features we've explored today demonstrate Cline's powerful capabilities, from workspace control to auto-approval settings and project-specific rules. While some features like the massive system prompt have room for improvement, understanding these tools can significantly enhance your development workflow. Remember to use these features judiciously, always considering the balance between automation and control in your development process. Thanks for watching. Happy coding!